Saturday Night Live, Will Ferrell, George W. Bush, Donald Trump.
Host Will Ferrell returns as Bush for SNL cold open. No, it's not 2007. And no, that's not a bad thing either. Saturday Night Live alum Will Ferrell returns to the hosting game on this week's episode. But before he hit the stage, he took a seat behind the Oval Office desk to reprise his place as former President George W. Bush. Ferrell's return addressed the sentiments many Americans have held in the past year. Maybe things weren't so bad under President Bush. To put it in fake Bush's own words, I'm suddenly popular AF. Even USA Today's editorial board released a piece at the end of December addressing some of Trump's more unsavory comments. A president who would all but call Sen. Kirsten Gillibrand a whore is not fit to clean the toilets in the Barack Obama presidential library or to shine the shoes of George W. Bush. But Ferrell's Bush didn't hold back, pointing out some of his own greatest hits, including the two wars he started, the cool 8K that the Dow plummeted under his command in the most iconic line. What has two thumbs and created ISIS? This guy. He didn't miss out on a chance to target former Vice President Dick Cheney's indiscretions either, later known for some of the more extreme moves of the Bush administration. Ferrell's Bush says, if you knew half the stuff Cheney was up to, you'd take no cakes for gays in a heartbeat. The whole thing rounded out with a version of Those Were the Days with Leslie Jones stepping in as Condoleezza Rice. We're not saying it should win a Grammy, but we'd download it for another listen. With 3 years remaining, Trump has his fair share of time to catch the flying shoes of Iraqi or American journalists, but the fact still stands, Bush is gone. As for how he's spending his time, I've been too busy doing oil paintings. Actually been too busy getting my MFA from University of Phoenix online.